Hello dear students, in this video we will discuss about the criteria for showing rotational spectra. So this is very simple concept. So already we have discussed what should be the criteria. Means to have a microwave spectroscopy or rotational spectroscopy, what one molecule should have a property. So the molecule, the property we have already discussed, but with this heading we will discuss again in the short term. Okay. So here the first thing is the molecule should have the permanent dipole moment. Okay. Isn't it? We have already studied this permanent dipole moment. Okay. So the molecule should have permanent dipole moment. Permanent dipole moment. The first criteria for showing the rotational spectra is permanent dipole moment. To show the rotational spectra, molecule such as the example for the permanent dipole moment, examples we have already studied, that was HCl and carbon monoxide. Carbon monoxide will show rotational spectra, whereas this H2O2 or CO2 will not show the rotational spectra because they don't have the permanent dipole moment. The second thing is the molecule should absorb the radiations. The molecule should absorb the radiations. Absorb radiations. The second criteria is it should absorb the radiations. So the radiations are absorbed in rotational levels only in case where the change in dipole moments takes place during the rotation. So whenever the rotation is taking place from end over to end, so it will be having the radiations. Whenever it is rotating, it should absorb that time. So absorb the radiations whenever it is rotating. The homonuclear molecules. The homonuclear means that is non-polar. Homonuclear means non-polar molecules. Like what was non-polar molecules? That is H2, Cl2 and some other have no rotational spectra. So here also we have seen that these molecules don't have permanent dipole moment, that is not showing the rotational spectra. Here also these are non-polar. So to have the rotational spectra with the molecules, we should have the polar molecules, not the non-polar. Not the non-polar. So these are non-polars, not showing the rotational spectra. So the third criteria is rotational spectra are observed with gases but not the with the solids. So these rotational spectra, the rotational spectra observed, rotational spectra observed with gases. Okay, gases, not solids. This is the third criteria, not solid. And liquids, as in these cases, the rotations of neighboring molecules interfere with one another. So the first criteria to show the rotational spectra, the molecule should have permanent dipole moment, and the second criteria should have a polar molecules and it should absorb the radiations whenever it is rotating. And the third condition is, the third criteria is gases will show the or observe with the rotational spectra, not solids or a liquids. So this is all about the criteria for showing the rotational spectra.